Welcome to Superior Profit Weekly Market Roundup, 23rd December 2017. I am Sagan Nandi, Chief Analyst and Trader at Superior Profit, a company based in Singapore. I will not take time to introduce myself. If you are interested to know more about me, the company Superior Profit, and more importantly, how it can help in your trading, you may visit the site superiorprofit.co and click on the About menu. Before we begin, we go through the standard disclaimer. This demonstration is for educational purposes only. It is designed to share information on Superior Profit's trading system. The information presented here should only be used by people who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. Past performance is no guarantee of future return. Superior Profit is not an investment advisor. This session is not for any recommendation of buying or selling stock or any other instrument. Superior Profit will have no liability for any investment decision made by its audience. In today's topics, we'll look at few key commodities because they tend to impact related stocks. We will look at oil and gold using technical charts. A rising tide lifts all boats. If the market goes up, it tends to take all the stocks along with it. That's why we study broad market to understand whether the overall market is going up, down or sideways. We'll look at this using market breadth of NASDAQ and NYSE, and we'll also look at technical charts of four broad market ETFs. If we can align our trades with industry's rotation, that adds more conviction, more edges to the trades. That's the reason we study industry rotation using scorecard and heat map. Along the way, we may look at some of the trades from Q Forum and also look for potential trades for the coming week. That was the last slide of the presentation. Let's move to live system. We start technical analysis of commodities with US oil. We are looking at USO, the oil ETF, using weekly backdrop template on the left side and daily hop-on template on the right side. Together, we call this at-a-glance template, because it helps us decide if there is a trade setup at the right edge of the chart just by having a quick look at it. In last weekly market roundup, we saw that there was a memory resistance line in the daily chart. And I had mentioned that we will know about oil's direction once that is broken. That breakout happened on this candle, Wednesday this week. However, there is still no Q trade setup. It is still bound by the watermark resistance at the top and memory at the bottom. In the weekly backdrop chart, the candle color is yellow, neutral, though the shape is bullish. In fact, the candle shape in weekly chart is bullish for several weeks now, though the price is not able to go up. Meaning every week price is trying to come down, but not staying down. It is recovering to the almost high of the week. We may get a clearer signal if oil breaks out of this watermark resistance, then tilts down, goes up again, giving us a proper go with flow long trade opportunity. Let's look at gold now. For 2 weeks, gold declined, and then 1 week before, it reversed, though the backdrop candle color was still bearish. At that time, price was somewhere near the value area in the daily chart. Based on that, in last roundup, I said that if gold came down from this price and gave us a magenta color, bearish flow color candle, that would give us a going flow short trade setup. However, as we can see, there was no magenta candle. Gold continued to go up. And now the weekly backdrop color has turned bullish, cyan. Therefore, even if price was to go down from the current level, it may not give us a going flow short trade anymore. This example illustrates the importance of studying the charts carefully using our unambiguous checklist. We may anticipate a trade, however, not pull the trigger, that is, not enter the trade until the signals are confirmed. There is a memory resistance in the weekly chart. It is there in the daily chart also, some distance away from the current price. Right now, there is no valid trade opportunity in gold. The weekly backdrop has turned bullish. So one possibility could be that gold comes down little bit and tilts up from there. That would give us a low risk, probably go with flow long trade opportunity. Right now, there is no Q trade set. After studying the two commodities, let's now move to broad market internal analysis using market breadth. Every week we study broad market using NASDAQ composite index and NYSE composite index, both using weekly charts. Because this analysis is using broad indices and weekly charts, it is to be used for long-term investment decisions, not for swing trading and certainly not for day trading. The indices themselves continue to go up. They are strongly bullish, there is no doubt about it. This week, NASDAQ traffic light candle color in the weekly chart turned yellow, that is neutral. It also displayed a bearish headwind signal. The candle shape itself is indecisive. Though it turned neutral and it displayed a bearish headwind, on a closing basis, it made another new all-time high. And NYSE clearly went up, made a new all-time high. It gapped up at open of the week and then continued to go up. A small range bar, but a hollow candle showing that the shape is bullish. NYSE is overbought and NASDAQ is also overbought as seen from the dots appearing on top of the candles. There is only one cautionary sign, that is the bearish headwind signal appearing in the NASDAQ weekly chart. Everything else about the two indices are strongly bullish. The internals themselves are not able to surpass previous peaks. Though the indices are making new all-time highs, the internals have not been able to do that. Last week, the up-down volume for both the indices did breach earlier peaks, but this week they declined again. Out of the total 6 internals, 5 internals declined. Only one internal went up, that is the new high low of NYSE. 4 of the internals closed positive, 2 closed negative. Therefore, in summary, we may conclude that the indices are clearly bullish. No doubt about that. Internals continue to be weak, unable to surpass previous peaks. For this specific week, internals are mixed or neutral. The market continues to be bullish. Let's see if the broad market ETFs give us the same conclusion. We are now looking at SPY using at-a-glance template. From the weekly, we see though SPY backdrop candle color turned yellow neutral, on a closing basis, it made a new all-time high. Activity for past 4 weeks had been either very high or high. This didn't happen for any weeks in the past. Actually, on the screen, we don't see any period where we had 4 successive weeks of high or very high activity. Daily chart shows that there was a bearish headwind signal that came 1 week ago. This week price went above that decline, giving another bearish headwind signal, and then price moved sideways for the 4 days. It closed just above the 2 watermark resistance levels. Both the weekly and the daily charts are bullish. Only some caution is shown by the 2 bearish headwind signals. Let's look at the other broad market ETFs. QQQ in the weekly backdrop chart opened with a gap up but closed below previous week's close. We can infer that from the red color of the activity bar. Here, activity is muted relative to SPY. QQQ displayed a bearish headwind in the weekly chart. In daily chart, last week it broke above the watermark resistance level, and this week, though it declined from open, it managed to close above the watermark resistance, just as was the case for SPY. The charts themselves are bullish. Again, the caution is warranted because of the weekly headwind signal. DIA is the strongest of the 3 ETFs, SPY, QQQ, DIA. The weekly backdrop is cyan, bullish. It opened with a gap up, declined a little bit from open. The candle shape itself is indecisive, very narrow range candle in the weekly chart. Activity had been heavy for the last 3 weeks. This week activity was not that high. Daily chart shows multiple bearish headwind signals. Both the weekly and the daily charts are again bullish. Again, caution is warranted because of multiple bearish headwind signals. These 3 broad market ETFs were in clear uptrend, and all of them are showing bearish headwind either in the weekly or the daily chart. In IWM, Russell 2000 ETF, the bearish headwind came 2 weeks ago. Previous week was indecisive shape candle. This week candle is bearish shape. The backdrop candle color is yellow. That is neutral. In daily, IWM is bound by memory resistance at the top, memory support at the bottom, inside a triangle formation. So it doesn't have any clear trend. Looking from the right edge, this is the only broad market ETF that is not having any clear trend. All the other three ETFs have clear trend and all of them have displayed bearish headwind signals. When that happens, one may be careful about entering new long positions. However, if one is holding profitable long positions, there is no necessity to exit them. One may just keep an eye on the stocks, and if one wants, one may put protect profit stop using Q protection signal or using previous swing low. Overall, the broad market breadth and the broad market ETFs both paint a bullish picture. Let's see if the sector and industry analysis confirms the same. Sector performance. Every week we study 11 economic sectors across 3 review periods. Red bar represents performance of this week, green bar performance of 1 week prior to red bar, and blue bar performance of 2 weeks prior to green bar. Together, they constitute 4 weeks or about 1 month of performance. Any bar coming to the right of 0 point indicates the sector went up, and a bar going to the left of the 0 point indicates the sector went down. Sector breadth deteriorated from previous week. If you remember previous week's graph, you know that it was very lopsided on the positive side. There were many more sectors with bigger up moves and very few with smaller down moves in previous week. That changed. This week the graph is more balanced. Still, 6 of the 11 sectors went up. So more went up. This market is more balanced now relative to previous week. Telecommunication continued to rise. It is now up for all the 3 review periods for the entire month. And through these market roundups or using QAG yourself, you could catch the very turning point of telecom and its related stocks. I had shared some trades on this sector. One was CenturyLink. That gave very high profit, went up straight from the bottom after showing a bullish headwind signal. Consumer discretionary is another sector where we could catch the very bottom. This week again it went up, however its score declined. In last roundup, we discovered several consumer discretionary industries were deteriorating with fast pace. Similar weakness is visible again this week. We look into that during industry analysis. Utilities went down and it became the worst performing sector this week. In last roundup, we expressed caution about utilities sector, and I mentioned that we should watch the sector and its stocks carefully. That warning was timely. There were probably some short opportunities in utilities, or at least an opportunity to protect profit in profitable long positions. This week, 4 sectors: real estate, information technology, financials and energy are showing flip-flop move. That is either up down up or down up down move across 3 review periods. This may give opportunities to buy the dip or short the rise. Let's look at financials as an example. In the current week it went up. 1 week prior to that, it went down. 2 weeks prior to that, it went up strongly. So it shows that last week was a dip in the financial sector from which it recovered this week. When the sector was starting to go up this week, it must have given us some buy the dip opportunity. Let me try to draw it on the whiteboard. For 2 weeks, financials was up. For 1 week, it was down. And then this week, it was up again. When this happened, we are sure that there was a dip between previous week and this week. This becomes obvious from the sector performance graph when we see up down up move, like in financials, up down up, or down up down move, as in case of information technology. So infotech may give us short the rise right at the top of the swing opportunity. Of course, the actual trade decision will be decided based on Q trade setups on at a glance template. Energy is the best performing sector this week. Its gradual and consistent rise is clearly visible in QH sector rotation table. When this happens, one may look for only long trades, because it is gradually and consistently going up. Before going to industry analysis, let's look at sector rotation table and see some of these from the heat map table. Every time we open QH, it calculates the performance of all the sectors, and it does the same for all the industries across 12 monthly periods, and then more frequently for recent periods. For each period, it assigns a score. Earlier, it used to use rank. Now, consistently across sector, industry, and stock, scoring ranking. We are only use scoring, only using scoring. That is, a larger number is assigned to a stronger item. 5 days period is our primary review period for deciding trade entry. I am sorting the sector over 5 days period, and we see energy is the best performing sector now. And it is gradually and consistently transitioning from magenta to cyan. This is what I mentioned, that it is steadily strengthening. These are the times for several months now. We may look for only long trades. Consumer discretionary was strong. We could catch the very turning point of this sector. Previous week, I mentioned that there was some weakness. This week, its score declined somewhat. And we see the pace column, 5 days column, weekly pace, is also magenta. Utilities had been weak for a long time. Real estate is the second worst performing sector. However, there is something interesting going on. Over 1 day period, it is actually the best performing sector. And in pace, we see that both over 1 day and 2 days period, it strengthened fast. You know exactly what this may mean. This may mean a turning point in real estate sector. We watched the same thing happening in telecom earlier. We saw the same thing happening in consumer discretionary and consumer staples. Now, we will wait to see if the same thing happens in real estate sector. We'll delve further into it when we do industry analysis. Let's start with industry analysis. We are studying the best performing industries of this week. Energy is the best performing sector this week by far, going up by more than 4-5%. In fact, the second best performing sector went up by about 2%. So energy is clearly the strongest sector. It is therefore not a surprise to see 5 of the best performing industries belong to energy. These are coal and consumable fuels, oil and gas drilling, oil and gas exploration and production, energy equipment and services, and oil and gas equipment and services. This sector is strong for a while now, and several of these industries are also strong for a while. So the best time to buy stocks, bottom catching opportunities, might have already passed. Yet the best performing of all these 5 energy industries, that is coal and consumable fuels, had a great performance this week, going up by almost 20% in a single week. This industry is also strong for many months. There is one stock after heavy activity range breakout as a result of earnings, which happened in October. Peabody Energy, BTU, had given multiple low-risk buy opportunities. This breakout was clearly visible from the clean chart template. We'll have a look at this stock, BTU, and track it starting from October 17 using new clean chart template. Let's have a look at this stock also, Halador Energy. It gave a trend following go with flow long opportunity on 15th December. That has already given more profit than the risk in the trend. And this stock was discussed as a potential buy candidate in market roundup on 9th December, 2 weeks ago. So let's look at BTU and HNRG both using Q charts. We are looking at BTU, Peabody Energy, using hop on template. This earnings was in August and okay, this earnings was in October, late October. It went up above this narrow range area. Let's move to clean chart template. The clean chart template shows the sideways range more clearly. After the earnings in late October, it broke out of the range and then went up. There were several cyan color candles. Subject to meeting all the checklist conditions, this could be potential go with flow long trade opportunities. Going back further, I see there was another earnings related gap. We don't like to chase earnings gap. However, once price came down, gave us a cyan color candle, that would have also given us a low risk go with flow long trade opportunity, either on this candle or maybe even on this candle. That is further away in the past. Similar movement happened in the recent earnings also. It gapped up, didn't go down but moved sideways for a while and then gave a series of cyan color candles. This was happening while the industry was going up, so you would be more confident in taking the long positions. If we took long position on this cyan candle, we would put stop just below recent low, so our risk would be small. If we took a long on this cyan color candle, our stop would be just below the recent low at this level. Again, risk would be small. The other stock was Halador Energy. This was discussed in the market roundup 2 weeks ago. We are going to look for go with flow long trade. Let's change the template to hop on template. 2 weeks ago, I had mentioned in the market roundup that it went up and made a higher high and suggested that if it came down to value area and gave a cyan color candle, that might give us a go with flow long trade opportunity. That cyan colored candle came on this day. Stop could be just below recent low. It seems that there are two memory resistance lines, not sure if they were there at that time. Even if the memory resistance lines were there, we see that our risk was this distance between stop loss and entry price, and by the time price came to the memory resistance lines, we would still cover more than the risk distance. Would I take such a trade? If the industry was not going up, I will personally avoid taking such a trade looking at the memory resistance lines. Another thing I would also like to look at is the fundamental of the stock. If the fundamental of the stock was strong, the industry was going up, then I might decide to take this long trade, go with flow long trade setup on this candle without worrying too much about the memory resistance lines. But if it is a pure technical trade, just looking at the chart, if the memory resistance lines were there, I will play safe and not take a trade at this point. A better opportunity would come if price breaks out of this memory resistance line, tilts down and goes up again. That would give us a low risk go through a long trade opportunity, and you can see there is no other memory resistance nearby. There is open space, so that will give us a more comfortable trend following long trade opportunity. Back to industry analysis. Marine industry. Last week we saw it was going up with fast pace, and as is often the case, it turned out to be one of the best performers this week. This once again shows that industry pace score is probably the closest you can get to predicting imminent industry moves. Looking at marine going up with fast pace 1 week ago, one might already take some long position in some marine stocks. This stock, Kirby Cox, KEX, went up after giving a trend following going through long signal on 18th December. Another stock in marine industry, C-SPAN, SSX, beautifully broke out of narrow range at pendulum low, going up by more than 20% in this single week. It may be worth keeping an eye on this stock. It is recovering from the very bottom. In the coming days, it may give us a low risk buy point. Right now, it is a bit overbought probably. We'll look at the chart. I'm thinking it may be overbought because it already went up 20% in this week. However, it was at the very bottom. So in coming days, if it dips a little bit and goes up again, that may be a very low risk buy point. And we may take it, especially if the marine industry continues to go up. Let's look at these two stocks, KEX and SSX, using Q charts. This is KEX using hop on template. It created a new high when price went up from this low, pulled back, created a higher low, and then gave us a cyan color candle. That is the signal for go it for a long trade, and this was happening when the industry was going up, first in terms of pace and then in terms of performance. So that would give us more confidence to take long trade. Stop would be just below recent low. This would be entry price. Our standard profit target for go with flow long trade is upper boundary. That was hit in 3 trading days. This was another example where we could do top down analysis to identify a trade. We could also identify using Q sonar, that is bottom up approach. The cyan candle means that it would have come in go with flow long scanner. The other stock in this industry was SSX, not SSX. Okay, If it is not SSX, let's go back to our industry analyst. So we are using QH now, sorting all the industries over our primary 5 days from strongest to weakest. You see Marine is one of them. It's beautifully and gradually transitioning from magenta to cyan. These are the industries, you know, that is of interest to me and many other Q traders. They are gradually going up, not whipsawing between magenta, cyan, magenta, cyan. Beautiful pattern to look for long trades. You can click this button to drill down. It's going to the universe, Thomson Reuters, looking for the stocks. Okay, it is SSW. I don't see any SSX. It must be SSW. Let's have a look at the stock SSW. Let's change it to more complete templates, where we see the watermark levels, both for weekly chart, also for the daily chart. C-span was at the bottom for a long time. This was one of the earlier weekly watermark levels. Tried to go below that, and this week strongly went up. Went up by more than 20%. It is clearly overbought, shown by the stretch dots. That's why I mentioned it is too late to take a trade right now. An ideal setup would be if it pulls back a little bit and goes up again. That would give us a low risk entry opportunity. SSW shows a nice pattern in the weekly chart. If it breaks above this memory resistance in weekly, which would coincide with the breaking of the daily memory as well, then it has open space, it may go up further, especially if the marine industry continues to go up. So this may be a stock worth keeping an eye on. Five of the worst performing industries are in real estate sector. We saw real estate sector is down for many months. It has a low score in sector rotation table, magenta color for many months. So the best time to short might have passed. As we saw, interestingly, over 1 day period, it has best score, and sector pace was also showing strength over 1 and 2 day periods. If we drill down, we'll see that multiple real estate industries are also apparently turning up with high pace over last few days. Therefore, this may give us an opportunity to locate the very turning point of the sector. Sector drill down shows that in real estate sector, retail rates was the best performer on Friday. And if we drill down further into retail rates, then we'll see multiple optimal valuation stocks that are also near 52-week low. And they may be nearing optimal buy point on Q charts. These are BRX, WPG, KIM, CBL, and DDR. Let's start with QH. Start with the real estate sector and drill down first to its industries and then to the stocks to see how we could step by step identify these stocks using top-down analysis. In sector analysis, we already saw that real estate was magenta over many months, turned out to be the strongest one on Friday, and pace is also cyan, strong over 1 day and 2 days periods. Drill down into all the industries by clicking this button, and we have the real estate industries here. We see many of them were magenta for a long time. Again, over 1 day period, most probably all of them strengthened. And the pace columns show they strengthened very fast. 1 day heat map color is cyan and the pace 1 day and 2 days columns are also cyan. We can sort over 1 day period largest to smallest, and that shows that on Friday retail rates was the best performer of all these industries. You can drill down into the retail rate stocks by clicking the components button. QVital is retrieving the data from Thomson Reuters. That is also Metastock Zenith. Found 31 stocks. We can click the calculator button to get the data about all these 31 stocks and calculate the Vital statistics. Another change we made in QVital and also in QH, anything that represents a score. Remember, we don't have any ranking now, only score. And all the scores use the color scheme of cyan, magenta, yellow, as we can see here. Whereas any column that is raw data, like dividend yield, percentage change, etc., these are not scores. These are based on raw data coming from Thomson Reuters. They use the color scheme of red, green, yellow. So we instantly know by looking at the color coding whether it is a score calculated by QTools or it's raw data coming from Thomson Reuters. To analyze these stocks further, you can click the investigate button, go to Vital Analysis, and let's identify the best value stocks that would have the cyan scores in relative valuation. There are multiple ways we could look at the stocks. Let's remove the stocks that are not at optimal valuation. Remember, this is an industry which was languishing for a long time and now just starting to go up. Therefore, we expect a buy opportunity to be at optimal valuation. We are not expecting it to have high growth. Now we can look at these stocks in multiple ways. Those who are using Q Global based on Metastock, now we have provided this feature, this copy button. You can click the copy button, open Power Console, just press Ctrl V. So all the symbols will come, and open it with the default template. For Q Global, we released some new templates. For all the templates that were having memory support resistance lines, we created a duplicate template with the prefix Q2 instead of prefix Q. And here you can individually select the memory support resistance lines and delete them if required. Sometimes we may want to delete them when the memory lines are compressing the charts too much. I will see if we find an example of that. So here I just transferred the symbols from QH, and you could do the same thing from QVital also, into QGlobal. This stock fell sharply. Clearly there is no buy opportunity. We just need few seconds. We are looking for buy opportunities. This one looks interesting. When something looks interesting, we want to look at it using at a glance template. So I have set up everything in the menu bar. So I click that, and here it is, the stock DDR. And instantly, I think you would agree that it looks interesting. It's a well-known stock. You see the daily chart has a memory resistance far away, actually multiple of them, which is compressing the chart. So this is the newer template where I could individually select them and delete, but the immediate memory resistance is still there. That's all that we need. We don't need so far away memory resistance. Let's see what are the interesting points. DDR clearly dropped a lot, created a swing low in the weekly backdrop chart, went up but breached that, displayed a bullish headwind that precisely caught the very bottom 3 weeks ago, 1 week ago, it sharply went up with extreme high activity. That made the price go up above upper boundary in the daily chart. So weekly created a false downside breakout, accompanied by possible exhaustion. Daily also created false downside breakout, and there was high activity earlier and also at this low point, this swing low point. In fact, when price went up on this sand color candle, it could be taken as a sideways market reversal long trend, especially if the industry was also strengthening. Not sure if it was starting to show signs of strength from this day itself. But if we could take a long trade, stop would be just below this recent low. Technically, I think there was a long trade opportunity because we also had a bullish headwind in the weekly chart. In any case, at the right edge, it went above upper boundary, pulled back a little bit. There is a memory resistance line. If next week it gives us a cyan color candle, what would you do? Normally, we would not like to take a long trade when the memory resistance is so close. However, we see there are some signs that the sector and this industry also starting to turn around, probably starting to turn around. We see that in the stock chart as well. So one approach, a little bit aggressive, could be to take a long trade, maybe Monday or Tuesday, if it gives us a long opportunity using real-time fine-tuned chart. That could be an early range breakout trade opportunity. And if that breakout in fine-tuned real-time chart results in breaking of the daily memory, we could simply hold on to the trend. And using real-time chart, we could see if the price is reversing from the memory resistance. If it does so, we would still be able to most likely exit that trade at break-even or with very small profit. That would be an aggressive way to enter a long position in this stock in an industry which may be turning around, and also the sector may be turning around. If we don't take this aggressive approach, that is also fine. In that case, we would need to wait for it to break out of the memory resistance till down and go back up again, giving us a low risk entry opportunity. So we came to at a glance chart of DDR because the daily chart looked interesting. Let's continue with the remaining stocks. This is also an interesting stock, Kimco Realty. See that this stock is inside triangle pattern, bound by memory resistance and memory support, and it is resting right on top of memory support. So next 1 day or 2 days, if it starts to go up, the candle color turns to neutral at least. Then one may take a long position, putting stop just below the memory support line. This may not be a standard Q trade setup, but if the industry continues to go up, then this may provide a very low risk entry opportunity. If it turns down, one would exit with very small stop. Let's continue with the remaining stocks. Ramco, Greshensan. Sorry about that. I don't know if the company name is, I am pronouncing it correctly, Ramco Greshensan. RPT is simpler. Just now we saw an example where we might be attempting to catch the very bottom. Such an opportunity happened in this stock at this point. Yeah, we could catch the second leg of the double bottom. The stock has already gone up. After bearish headwind display, it pulled back a little bit. If it goes up next week, I am not that comfortable taking a long trade here because it is moving inside support and resistance, bottom market effects, moving sideways. If we look from the right edge, it is moving sideways. I would be more confident taking a long trade in DDR compared to this. This looks quite good also. Whitestone red. It is already in uptrend, pulled back little bit at the right edge and resting right on top of the memory support. So if it goes up, it will again give us a very low risk entry opportunity. I am always looking for low risk entry opportunities. And these stocks that we are looking at all are optimally valued. So fundamentally, we can say they are strong. If the industry is also going up, I think these are good low risk buy points. BRX, Brixmor, also looks interesting. It's moving sideways for a while. There was a bullish headwind. So far, it is catching the very bottom. Friday's candle is indecisive. Color is cyan. There is a memory resistance line. So in this case, I would probably wait for the memory to be broken. Or I would wait for it to come to the memory support and try to take a long from there. Looks interesting, definitely. WPG also came down in the daily chart and then moving sideways for a while. Some heavy activity came in, prices holding on to the base. Friday's candle color turned cyan. There is a memory resistance very close. So next week, if price goes above the memory resistance, we may take a long entry there. I am not fond of breakout trades except when a breakout gives me a very low risk entry, like in this case. If, for example, Monday's open is just above the memory resistance, that could be a potential long entry point with stop just below the recent low. If that is the case, let's have a look at it through at a glance template. Weekly, daily, both. Weekly is also interesting. It displayed a bullish headwind earlier from where price went up. It pulled back again. It has three successive weeks of bullish shape candles. Every time price is trying to calm down but recovering and closing near the top of the week. If this memory resistance is broken, I would think it has more likelihood of going up than going down. Last one, CBL, also looks interesting. We can see several stocks in this industry declined in the recent period and then starting to move sideways. Let's look at it through at a glance. See, this chart is not as interesting to me as was the last chart. In the last chart, three successive weeks, it was trying to go down and recover, go down, recover, go down, recover. Whereas this chart, CBL, has multiple weeks of indecisive candle in terms of shape. So I would prefer to enter long in the previous stock than in this stock. So I think looking at these stocks, we found WPG, WSR, DDR, if I'm remembering correctly, at least these three potential long trade opportunities. No signal yet, but they may give signal next week and we'll be more confident taking them if this industry, their industry retail rates is continuing to strengthen, especially if the 5 days period turns cyan. That's why we call 5 days period our primary interval for deciding trade entry. Let's continue with the worst performing industries. Weakness in utility sector was already discussed in the previous week. This week, three of the worst performers are in utilities: electric utilities, multi-utilities and gas utilities. Utilities as a sector is down for a while, and electric utilities industry is also down for a while. The stock PPL has poor growth in QVITAL, has given a series of profitable trend following short opportunities. And as the industry was weak for many months, we could probably take all of them. That would still align the chart setup with the industry's weakness. And there were probably many other opportunities. PPL might not be only one. Right now, because these industries are down for a while, the best opportunities to short might have passed. But let's look back and have a look at PPL. PPL, belonging to electric utilities, started going down from this point onward. It tried to recover after displaying the bullish headwind signal. Then on this candle, it gave a valid go with flow short trade setup. Another one on this candle. I see that earnings was nearby. So if somebody was taking a bearish trade on this candle, that would be using probably short call verticals. It might be too risky to short using stock just before earnings. But short call verticals would work just fine. Another go with flow short trade setup came on this candle. Earnings was already over. Another on this candle. All of them were very profitable. As the industry was steadily declining, using our way of trading, we might hold on to partial position. By doing that, we would be able to take the short maybe at this point or this point, and then still holding partial position. Every time it creates a swing high, we may move stop there. That is one approach for longer term trading. And by doing that, we are still holding the remaining position. At the right edge, it is declining sharply. The last swing high is very far. In that case, we may use the Q protection signal. Let's see if I can switch to Q protection signal. Hop-up template. From this swing high, if we are using the Q protection signal, you see that it has never been breached on a closing basis. And right now, our stop would be at 30 to 25. This again illustrates how beautifully the Q protection signal can protect profit using it as a trailing stop. One approach would be to switch to Q protection signal for trailing stop. Another approach could be that, okay, the trade has already given long profit. Even if it goes up, let it go up. Let's see if another swing high comes and move stop there. If the industry is continuing to weaken, that is also possible. But if the industry is starting to turn up, then I would probably use the trailing stop of Q protection signal. I will not wait for this large profit to be eroded, which may happen if the industry starts to go up. Right now, there is no sign that it is going to go up. We came here to illustrate how, while the industry was going on, one stock in that industry gave a series of short trade opportunities. All of them ended up being very profitable. And as I mentioned, this was probably not the only stock in utilities industries while they were declining. Every week, we also look at industries going up with fast pace. Often they end up being the best performer in subsequent weeks. We saw that happening in marine industry this week. It was going up with fast pace 1 week ago. This week it is best performer. Six of the accelerating industries are in consumer discretionary sector. This seems to be related to big ticket items. Automobile manufacturer, automotive retail, automobile again, distributor, consumer electronics, home furnishing retail. Probably people are expecting to spend their tax windfall this way. that could be a hypothesis. However, Q traders may rely more on objective data. Remember earlier I mentioned that as a sector, consumer discretionary had some warning signs even 1 week ago. And now we see that six of its industries are going up with fast pace. That seems to be at odds with each other. That caught my attention and I drilled down. When I looked at these industries using QH, I saw that the heat map is not that bullish. In the industry analysis, I can refresh the data by clicking the investigate button, sort the industries on pace column, strongest ones at the top. And many of them are belonging to consumer discretionary sector. Automotive, retail, automobile manufacturer, automobile, etc. See the industry's heat map. Not looking bullish. Not for automobile manufacturer, not for automotive retail, not for automobiles, not even for home furnishing retailer. We always combine all the data and try to take a trade when more and more edges are in our favor. For example, home furnishing retail had 14 score, not rank, score. Now it is 118. That's a big jump. But then it lost score again. These are spotty areas. Cyan, magenta, cyan, magenta, cyan, magenta. These are not areas where we confidently take a trade. Where do we confidently take a trade? Let's sort it again over 5 days column. Look at marine industries. It is gradually and steadily turning from weakness to strength. These are the industries where we prefer to take long trade, not industries which are switching between cyan, magenta, cyan. So, though multiple consumer discretionary industries apparently went up, did go up with fast pace, but none of them have a heat map that is appealing for taking a long trade. What about construction? US President made a commitment to build a big wall along the border with Mexico. There is some report that he may be traveling to the border to review prototypes. And we see construction materials went up with fastest pace. It may be also driven by housing market, may be driven by the possibility of border wall. Not sure if the wall is going to be made of concrete, but probably some concrete will be there, maybe a lot of concrete. And this stock, US Concrete, USCR, signaled a trend following long on Thursday. It also has one of the better relative valuation in QVITA. Let's look at construction materials in QA, drill down to the stocks, and then look at the chart of US Concrete. Construction materials went up with fastest pace. And this is steadily changing color from magenta to cyan, unlike the consumer discretionary industries. So this is one where we might look for long trade. Also, over 5 days, it is already cyan. Over 2 days and 1 day, it is holding on to the color and the score. You can click the components button. It has found number of stocks. You can click the calculator button to retrieve the data about these stocks and calculate VITA statistics. We see this stock USCR. Let's wait for the VITA statistics to be completed. We see that this is yellow. Not best valuation, but not worst either. We have two stocks which have better valuation, but they have suffix of PK. Probably they are very small stocks. So we are not going to look at them. Out of the non.pk stocks, USCR and USLM, these two are yellow, so better valuation than others. That's what I mentioned in the graph. And on chart, USCR is looking interesting. This is USCR using Hopman template. Here it went up to the upper boundary, made a higher high, came down to value area, made a higher low, and on Thursday gave us a cyan color candle. That's a go with flow long trade setup. We could take it right at close of Thursday, stop just below recent low, and our standard profit target would be at the upper boundary. Another construction related industry, construction and engineering, also went up with fast pace. And in this industry, KBR is optimally valued and may give a long opportunity next week. I will not go to Q Vital, but let's look at the chart. Just like US Concrete, it went up to the upper boundary, pulled back, went to value area, moving sideways, then gave a cyan color candle that broke above the narrow range. Now pull back little bit. Next week, if it gives a cyan color candle again, one may take a long trade. We see that Friday's candle was very narrow range candle. So Monday, if it starts to go up, one might try to take a long trade using fine-tuned template, maybe using a range breakout technique. Lastly, we look at the industries going down with fast pace. Three consumer discretionary industries are here. And we saw the sector score also went down. These are footwear, movies, entertainment, textile, apparel, and luxury goods. Nike is interesting. NKE dropped beautifully after displaying headwind reversal signal that caught the exact very top. This is another example of why you may be careful, and I am careful, when the headwind signal appears. Will NKE give you a short setup in coming days? We'll look at that. These two industries, footwear and textile apparel and luxury goods, are showing smooth transition from strength to weakness. That is from cyan to magenta, opposite to what we saw in case of marine industries, opposite to what we saw in construction materials. So you may be cautious of holding any long position. Probably avoid any new buy position also. In textile, apparel and luxury goods, Under Armour is one stock that didn't participate in the industry's up move. The industry was cyan for quite a long time, but this stock, UAA or UA, another symbol for the same stock, it didn't recover. When that happens, that stock may be really weak or something going wrong. So even if it shows an opportunity, apparent opportunity to catch the bottom, I suggest staying away from such stock. Why? Because the industry recovered a lot, but the stock didn't. Now the industry is starting to weaken. If the industry was continuing to go up, then maybe I would consider buying UA at the bottom. But the industry is starting to turn down. We'll look at the heat map also. So that is not a time to take a long position in an apparent weak stock. We can contrast that with VF Corporation, another apparel company, which went up strongly from the bottom while the industry was going up. But now moving sideways for several days, you may keep an eye on this and make sure that profit doesn't erode. Let's quickly look at these three stocks, UA, VFC and Nike. Before looking at the stocks, let us look at the industries. We are looking at industry analysis, sorting over pace column, weakest ones at the top. Footwear is one that is smoothly transitioning from cyan to magenta. Over 5 days magenta, and then magenta is holding over 2 days and 1 day period. The same is true for textile, apparel and luxury goods. magenta over 5 days, holding over 1 day period. These are not the times to look for new buy positions in these industries. So I had drilled down already and analyzed these few stocks. Let's look at their charts. Under Armour clearly didn't participate in the up move of the industry. What I was suggesting is not to try a long trade here, because industry had already gone up considerably. Many stocks participated in that up move, but this didn't. And now the industry may be turning down, or at least not going up, as seen from pace column. Not a good time to enter long position in a weak stock like eBay. And now see VFC. VF Corporation went up straight in the weekly chart, almost straight. Clearly participated in the up move. Let's change to advanced hop-on template to see the watermarks. Looking from the right hand side, we see that it is now range bound. In fact, the bearish headwind again in daily chart has caught the very top so far. If we look at the weekly candles, it had been yellow or magenta for 4 weeks. Therefore, when this bearish headwind came, probably it gave us a valid headwind short trade setup, swing trade setup that was very profitable. Price tried to come back to the same high of the bearish headwind signal and failed again. I mentioned many times earlier, after bearish headwind that pulls the price down, if price tries to come back to the headwind level, there may be some selling left still. What about Nike? Nike went up strongly as footwear went up. Again, in daily chart, the bearish headwind precisely caught the very top. It was just before earnings, so one might not short using stock, but short call vertical will be very appropriate. Interestingly, on Friday, it opened with a large gap down, which came precisely to the memory support, tried to go below that. After open, it went down, recovered. A day trader might keep that in mind and using fine-tuned chart, take a long trade right at the open as it went back up. That day trade would be very profitable. Though it recovered significantly from the gap down open, on a closing basis, you see it closed down significantly, in fact. Not only that, it actually closed below the low of Thursday. You can see that more clearly from fine-tuned chart. It closed below the low of Thursday. What are the possibilities? If it reverses from here, or maybe go up little bit and go down, there may be some more selling left as a result of these earnings and may give us a low risk short entry opportunity. Right now there is no such setup. One may keep an eye for that. Certainly, looking at the industry heat map and the stock chart, one might not consider taking a new buy position. There are many other interesting opportunities that we can get from industry analysis. Let's sort the industries again from let's do smallest to largest. What we are looking for is a steady transition from cyan to magenta or magenta to cyan. So footwear was one turning magenta. Here a lot of industries are weak, but they had been weak for a long time. Not that interesting, because the best time to short might have passed. Let's scroll down. This looks interesting. Hypermarket and supercenter and diversified support services. They are steadily transitioning from cyan to magenta. hypermarket supercenters, companies like Walmart, Costco, diversified support services. Let's drill down, retrieving the data. Click the calculator to calculate vital statistics. Then we will try to look at the overvalued stock, because the industry had been strong for a while, now changing color to magenta. So we are going to look for stocks that are overvalued. You can click the investigate button, go to vital analysis, sort by relative value, smallest to largest. The weakest one comes to the top in terms of relative valuation. Now these are the stocks we would like to look at. I demonstrated using the copy button how to transfer the stocks to Q Global or Meta stock. But if I am using Q Vital, I will come to the ticker symbol list. Remove these stocks, not of any interest, because I am looking for overvalued stocks. Then simply come to the ticker symbols, copy them, go to my trade station, and it is in radar. Click and paste. Now I can go through this stock list one by one. What are these stocks? These stocks belong to an industry that was strong earlier, now weakening. This stock is of no interest. Let's just quickly go through them. Each chart should take only a couple of seconds. We are looking for short opportunity, not this one. Two sideways, no, just on top of memory support, not going to short it. This one looks interesting. This went up as the industry went up. Copart Incorporation displayed a bearish headwind, and it seems to be toppling over. There is no trade setup yet, but it seems to be weakening as the industry is also weakening. If one is having a long position, one may be carefully watching it and protect profit. Let's look at the three remaining stocks. UNF. This is interesting also. Again, it participated with the industry's up move, had a bearish headwind in weekly that pulled down price. Another bearish headwind has come this week. The weekly backdrop candle shape is bearish. Color is neutral. Daily had a bearish headwind few days ago. Price tried to go up but failed and now closed below the high created by the bearish headwind. Displayed another second bearish headwind as well. This is showing multiple signs of weakness while the industry also seems to be weakening. Again, a case where you may be careful if you are holding a long position. There is no short signal yet, but may watch for one. Last two stocks, CTAS, also showing signs of weakness, bearish headwind in weekly as well as daily. Friday's candle is indecisive. You see, again, it precisely bounced up from the memory support. If these memory support lines are broken, I will be probably exiting in a long position if I was holding in. Showing weakness, again a stock that participated with industry's up move, and as the industry is weakening, this is also showing some signs of weakness. Last stock, PNTR, again showing signs of weakness in the daily, has a false upside breakout, weekly candle shape is bearish, there is memory support line. If the memory support is broken, I will be careful. This was an example of industry that was weakening. Let's sort it in the reverse order. Industry that is strengthening, wireless telecom. Very nice pattern, magenta to cyan, may look for long opportunities. Household appliances, may look for that as well. This pattern is very interesting for long position. Magenta to cyan. Cyan over 5 days and holding on to the color over 2 days and 1 day. You may do further analysis using QH and that is top-down analysis, or you could simply run sonar to look for trade setups first on the charts and then go back up to look for their fundamentals and industry. Let's summarize. Market breadth, broad market ETF sector industry analysis. Everything is showing that the market is bullish. Even in a bullish market, there are industries that may go down. We may analyze them from QH. Some sector like real estate and multiple industries in that sector may be turning up from the very bottom. Those may give us very good opportunities to buy strong fundamental stocks at the very bottom. You may keep an eye for that. That is all that I wanted to share in today's session. Thanks to you all again for joining. I look forward to seeing you in our next session. Have a great weekend. Trade profitably and Merry Christmas.